you'll get to see, like, there is, like, a coffee shop or a bar or, like, people that live around these people that lives are affected. You know, you'll feel more like a real texture.
Yeah, gritty, and, you know, we're going to sort of discuss and see how Vincent navigates through a world and through New York City where there is cameras and Twitter and, you know, Facebook and, you know, kind of legends of the, you know,
yes,
the world.
Legends of the beast.
Of the beast. So we're going to address all that, and I think that's really going to make the show a lot more richer. And we're actually going to travel and shoot scenes in New York.
Yes.
To really, you know, give that authentic quality of New York City.
Excellent. So, this show, the new season starts 3 months after the season finale. Vincent's gone for 3 months.
Yep.
How are you?
A mess. She's a mess. She's a mess without letting herself be a mess. Catherine's just, I think this is all she's been doing. Looking for Vincent, drinking coffee, possibly some alcohol, running.
And reading Cosmopolitan.
She doesn't have time for Cosmo, I don't think. Unless Vincent's in it.
Cover.
Yeah. Oh, there's Vincent. Right. He's got a modeling studio. Oh my god. but yeah, that's all she's been doing. And her life is falling apart around her without her really realizing it's falling apart.
She hasn't given up.
Gosh, no. Catherine give up on Vincent? Not gonna happen.
Never.
No. Unlikely.
Then we wouldn't have a show.
It's kind of, it's her, it's a good trait and a bad trait of hers.
Kristin, you have been on Smallville for a very long time.
That's true.
And Avengers made $1.5 billion. Would you be interested in a role in Avengers? Maybe you would be the perfect West, for example. I can literally see you.
I don't know how to answer that.
Yes, you would be interested in a role in Avengers.
That's how I see it.
Should I send that to Jocelyn?
Yes, I mentioned Joss is a, he's amazing, so. Yeah.
Or like maybe in the new Star Wars movies.
Oh my god, I mean,
yes,
these are lovely ideas. How about you go and tell everybody? Yes.
Speaking of Lana, I thought you hit it out of the park with her. Her evolution during those 10 years was a lot more than the character ever had in any film. Well, maybe the movie.
She changed massively.
Yeah,
that was really fun for me. I love transformational journeys. I mean, I think that's why we watch things, but she did change her a lot. I'm proud of that.
And you stepped behind the camera on Smallville.
I didn't on Smallville. No. Allison directed a couple episodes of Smallville back then. I don't know who I'm going to direct. but I've learned a lot on this show about the process of making a show that I am endlessly grateful for. Yeah.
What's on your TiVo? What shows are you watching besides your own?
I've become a late comer to Game of Thrones.
It's a good show.
Which is just amazing. I haven't watched a lot of television for a good year because we've been working so much. I became a dad. I've been very busy. So I got a week off last weekend. Caught up on Game of Thrones, and I was just, you know, in awe of how dense and complicated it is.
And if I can throw some good karma at you guys, guess what program George R.R. Martin worked on?
Beauty and the Beast.
Exactly.
I know.
That looks like,
oh, wow.
Yeah, he did.
On the
road,
Ron Thurman show.
Yes, he did.
No, I did not know that.
Yes, he did.
He wrote on it.
Very cool. 6 degrees of separation.
Not even.
Are there any more teasers for season 2 you can give us? Like, what
for
can we expect
two.
For season 2?
What
do
we talk?
Well, you know, the audience are going to be a couple of steps ahead of the characters in season 2, which is going to be a new tactic that the writers are going to go
with. Yeah, because then they can scream at the television.
Yeah, it makes it more nail-biting television, I think.
And yell on Twitter.
And yell on Twitter. I think there'll be more yelling on Twitter this year.
God, I don't know if there can be more yet. what else? You know, I think we'll discover the JT and Vincent backstory and the ultimate reasons for their friendship. And we're really going to see a bit more of Jekyll and Hyde in Vincent and his beast and man sort of moments, I guess.